I was unbelievably flattered because I wasn't expecting the students to feel that way, but obviously I was really humbled that they did.
To be honest, I think the whole school heard me. I was jumping about, I was laughing and screaming, I think I even did a little bit of a dance.
However, I was also grateful because it just shows my hard work and students appreciate the support I give them in lessons.
Shock, surprised, and then terrified because I remembered I'd have to do a video. An interview. But no, I was really, really proud.
A little bit of shock because I didn't actually think kids were going to vote for me because I think we're seeing a little bit as the devil when it's a pastoral role. But I was made up that the kids value me as a member of staff in Halewood.
I was shocked, high-fived all the kids that I was working with.
I was really surprised, but I'm really grateful that all my help and support is appreciated.
I had to take a second take, really. You know, is that my name? I was in front of my Year 10 class at the time, who were love as well. And they all started clapping, cheering. It was, you know, a really, really proud moment for me.
I didn't even know it was on. The kids were actually voting, so someone said to me, I voted for you.
When I look at all of the staff in the school, I think really, to be honest, everyone is kind of a winner. And I think that was shown when the head teacher sent out emails to so many staff that had got a nomination.
Try and make my lessons more enjoyable, more engaging, more like easier for students because I'm working in smaller groups, so I get to get their relationships across a lot easier so I can make the work more suitable for them.
I think because I try to make my lessons as fun as possible. And I also try to get to know my students individually rather than see them as a class. I like to know them individually and what makes them tick and what they enjoy and what they don't enjoy.
I filled a full assembly with lots of silly dancing, lots of cheering, vote manly, and a lot of fix your tie, tuck your shirt in and don't forget vote manly.
I do get on really well with the kids. The role that I do, I come into contact with all years, all different abilities, all different kinds of students. And I get on really well with them. I try and treat them like I treat my own daughter.
I think maybe because I have a really good relationship with the students in our year group, and quite often it's me who has to play the good cop role.
Well, I'm passionate, you know, I'll do absolutely anything I can for the pupils. I absolutely love the pupils that I teach. You know, I stay here all hours, marking exercise books, planning lessons. And I just love, you know, I've worked here for nearly 10 years now. I absolutely love the pupils that I teach, and that's why I do work here for them.
I'm always here, everyone always sees me, I'm always around, my face is everywhere. I think that's what it is.
You walk through the door in the summer, and actually what you've got is some unbelievably happy students that are going off to do what they want to do for the rest of their life. And actually you're thinking to yourself, well, hopefully I've had a little part in their success, and that is the main thing.
I think Miss Catchell should be the unsung hero because she is always willing to help a student even if it's not one of her own. She is so dedicated, and her warm, kind-hearted nature lights up my days and never fails to make me laugh.
Just day to day, when you see that those light bulb moments with students, when students, you know, find something really, really difficult, then all of a sudden it clicks.
I think Miss Tam should be Teacher of the Year because she's always willing to go the extra mile for her students. Every single student in her class succeeds, and she always has a lovely smile that brightens the day.
Working with small Year 11 groups in intervention and getting them their grade fives, because when they came back in the summer for the results, they were so made up, and getting a hug and getting that tear from them students just shows you that my work's done really well for them, so they can progress now to college.
I chose Mr. Bailey because he's supportive, friendly and always there if we need some help.
Wow, well, I have been here 16 years, so there's been quite a few, and too many to list in that time. I'm quite lucky that the students make me proud every day. And I think driving to work of a morning, I would say I see a lot of past students getting the buses going to college or going to work. And I do like to think that maybe I played a little part in that. And it is, it's nice, the kids make me proud every day.
I believe Miss Henry should get Teacher of the Year award because she makes her lessons very engaging and she gets to know you on a personal level rather than just as a student.
Getting picked for this, I've never been picked for anything before, ever. I think this is the best bit.
I've been part of Halewood since I was 11, so I came to school here, did my A-levels here, was a TA here, and now I'm pastoral. So my proudest moment is seeing the school develop from what it was to what it now is, and seeing how strong the staff are.
Yeah, when I first started, I worked with a student who was a little bit off the rails. Very de-schooled, didn't like coming in. His behaviour was awful. And by the time he finished in year 11, we were taking him up to colleges up in the city centre. And he got a place there, and I was really made up for him, because when I first started here, he was on the verge of getting kicked out and being arrested all the time. I was quite proud of that.
He helps students in every year and doesn't get enough credit for what he actually does for the students here at Halewood Academy.
The students that I've worked with progress really well, and I see them making the changes for the better.
I prefer Mrs. Trainer, as she is always there when I need her support. She is also my mentor, so she always pushes me to be the best I can in school and out of school.
There was a pupil who lost. She lost her mum on Christmas Day, and she lost her dad just before Easter, and I got really upset at the time. I made it my mission to ensure that she passed the GCSE. I didn't teach her at the time, but it was my mission to ensure that she got there. She got a B in the end, which was absolutely delighted. That's my proudest moment, but also going above and beyond for her as well to ensure that she could go to the school prom. Sending an email around to staff, raising £350 to ensure that she could buy a prom dress, that she could put all her hair in, make sure she had all her makeup, what the girls do nowadays, making sure that she was ready for prom. And the fact that she got a B in a GCSE at the end of it just topped everything off.